chaired by the Nakawa West MP Joel Senyonyi, COSASA is investigating into the operations of the National Lotteries and Gaming Board following queries composed in the Auditor General's report for the financial year 2021-2022. However, responding to matters arising during the committee meeting, some of the officials clashed before the lawmakers. Ronald Kimanje, a member of the Internal Procurement Committee, told lawmakers that he resigned from the committee last year after the executive director, Dennis Mudene Ngabirano, attempted to influence decisions.
Our CID, we are going to require you to pique interest in this matter, and we investigate more, because it's a serious issue as far as I'm concerned. When there is an allegation and it is your staff mentioning these things, you know, even interference of the CEO mentioned by a staff member, it's something because we are interested in the health of this entity.
Probed further by Senyonyi on what was at stake by the time of his resignation, Kimanje revealed that at a time they were considering the procurement of biometric machines for office access, but the executive director wanted the contracts committee to arrive at decisions even without quorum. Ngabirano, who served on the contracts committee, being elevated to the office of the executive director of the National Lotteries and Gaming Board, denied peddling any influence on which service providers' contracts were awarded. COSASA decided that officials mentioned in the scandal are sent to police for further interrogation.
Allegations that we were raised here by your staff are serious, and would like that police speak statements from you people so that we get to the bottom of these issues, yeah? So Mr. CEO, Madam Deborah, together with Kemo Grace and Kim Chimanji, Mr. Chimanji, you are going to go with our police officers.
Another clash before COSASA was between Deborah Kitui, the manager legal affairs, and Grace Keno, the manager enforcement, over allegations that the former solicited a bribe from a baiting company that had been closed over non-compliance issues. Testifying on oath, as was the case for all National Lotteries and Gaming Board officials, Kemo told the lawmakers that an officer in Golden Tripod, a baiting company, alleged that the manager, legal and board affairs, had asked for a bribe of 50 million shillings to reopen the baiting shop.
We discuss it in management, and I'm actually surprised that this issue of Golden Tripod is just coming to me for the first time. If at all there's any issue, then it would have come up in management.
Are the premises owned by the board, or you are renting?
We are renting, Honourable Member.
How was it acquired?
National Lotteries and Gaming Board officials were also quizzed on what lawmakers called suspected exaggerated expenditures, but they did not have documentary evidence to back up the budgets. Key among the queries that require documentation to back up the management explanation in the financial statements include 310 million shillings for car hire, 108 million shillings for motor vehicle repair, and 11.2 billion shillings for procurement of monitoring systems.
Consultancy?
Yes.
You people did work with them, right?
Yes, they did.
What was that work, and to the tune of what amount?
It was a business process re-engineering consultancy. I think it was about 92, 93. I can confirm.
98 million.
Million, yeah.
Yeah, so what did they do exactly?
They did business process re-engineering. Basically, is this entity had to come into our office, look at how we conduct our processes with the view of aligning them to have them automated.
Request for proposals as the...
No. The method of procurement. Did you find the method of procurement competitive?
Yes, there were three or four. We'll have to cross-check.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.